In this tutorial, we will explain how to calibrate the pressure sensor using the single and multiple set point methods in the DirectCommand ISOBUS liquid control module. Performing an accurate pressure sensor calibration is required to use pressure-based rate control and other pressure-based features like droplet size monitoring. You should be on the run screen of the DirectCommand ISOBUS liquid control module in the universal terminal to begin. Tap the gear icon on the right side of the screen. Here the white dashes indicate that no pressure sensors are configured yet. Tap the pressure sensor button. We need to select a sensor to calibrate, but none are listed, so we first need to configure a sensor. Tap the wrench. Our example sprayer has one Ag Leader electronic pressure sensor installed on the main boom supply line. We need to specify whether the installed sensor type is voltage or current loop. Ag Leader sensors are always voltage. Because our sensor is in the main line, tap the drop-down under Main and tap Voltage. Then tap the green check. Now that the main pressure sensor is configured, it is available to calibrate. Tap the next arrow to begin the calibration process. We will perform the single point method first. The single set point method uses the factory calibration number on the pressure sensor, and it's based on one sensor reading when the line has zero pressure. Use this method if you know the sensor calibration number or the pressure range and voltage or current range for the sensor. Tap the drop-down and select single set point. Tap the next arrow. On this screen, we will need to enter the sensor calibration number. Ag Leader sensors use a calibration value of 16 millivolts per PSI, so we will enter 16 here. If you don't know the calibration number, it can be calculated from other known values using the Derive Sensor Calibration Wizard. Tap the next arrow. On this screen, the real-time voltage measurement from the sensor is shown. Before we press record set point, we need to relieve all pressure on the sprayer so that the sensor is truly reading zero pressure. Residual pressure can be present in the system due to nozzle body check valves on the boom or any other check valves on the sprayer. To easily achieve zero pressure at the sensor, drain the line that the sensor is installed on. Once the sensor is truly reading zero pressure, tap record set point. Then tap the next arrow. The calibration is complete. In the single set point method, the DirectCommand ISOBUS liquid control module assumes the user has entered an accurate pressure sensor calibration number and there is no verification test. To save the calibration, tap the green check. The pressure sensor is now calibrated as indicated by the green check. The second option to calibrate the pressure sensor is the multiple set point method. This calibration also uses a sensor reading at zero pressure, but adds a second set point at a non-zero pressure. Use this method if you don't know any of the factory sensor calibration values, or if you would like to verify the known calibration number. Before you begin, an accurate analog pressure gauge must be installed on the line. Tap the pressure sensor button. Tap the next arrow to begin the calibration process. Tap the drop-down and tap multiple set point to choose it as the calibration method. Then tap the next arrow. On this screen, the real-time voltage measurement from the sensor is shown. Before we press record set point, we need to relieve all pressure on the sprayer so the sensor is truly reading zero pressure. Just like with the single point calibration, we recommend draining the line the sensor is installed on so we avoid residual pressure from check valves. Once the sensor is truly measuring zero pressure, tap record set point. Then tap the next arrow. Now we need to record a non-zero pressure reading. Use the up and down arrows to increase or decrease the flow rate until you reach your desired pressure. For this example, we are going to increase the flow rate until our analog pressure gauge reads 25 psi. Then tap the calculator icon and enter 25 psi or whatever pressure is shown on your gauge. Tap the green check. To record the voltage measurement at that pressure, tap Record Set Point. Then tap the next arrow. The multiple set point calibration is complete and the final sensor calibration number is shown. To save the calibration, tap the green check. Tap the running man to return to the run screen. Now you will be able to calibrate the pressure sensor using the single and multiple set point methods, so you can accurately use pressure-based control and monitoring features. For more information on the DirectCommand ISOBUS liquid rate module, please refer to the ISOBUS liquid feature user guide. If you'd like to see more short tutorials from Ag Leader, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.